Graded Stakes Racing continues, and this time we go to Keeneland Racing as it was meant to be, opening weekend for the Fall Meet 2023. And at Keeneland on Saturday, it is the Breeders' Futurity. It is a two-year-old race for grade one, two-year-olds going a mile and a 16th. It's going to go as race number nine, all part of a big card on Saturday that includes the Keeneland Turf Mile. Don't forget, we've got a preview up of the Alcibiades Stakes for two-year-old fillies on Friday. You can watch that right here on the channel. Let's take a look at this nine-horse field, starting off with the Wine Steward. 3 for 3 by Vino Rosso. Michael Maker trains, and a big win in his debut by 6 at Belmont. Last time out, won the Funny Side Stakes. This New York bred comes in 3 for 3 with Luis Saez. Timberlake, second in the grade one hopeful. The speed figure came back slow that day, but in the prior start at Ellis Park, picked up a 93 Brisnet, winning by 9 lengths for Timberlake. Awesome Road, a debut winner at Churchill Downs. By Quality Road, out of an AP Indy mare. This one, 1 for 1 lifetime, goes for trainer Brad Cox and jockey Flavian Pratt. Baytown Chatterbox, 5 lifetime starts, 2 wins, a win at Ellis and a win at Indiana. West Saratoga won the Iroquois Stakes. That was at a little bit of a price, 12 to 1 the last time. Before that, won at Ellis Park at 4 to 1. 6 starts, 2 wins, 3 seconds for West Saratoga on the quick turnaround from the mile win in the Iroquois. Generous Tipper is 1 of 2 for Ken McPeak. Picked up a win last time out by 7 lengths. That was in his third lifetime start. Debuted on the turf. Then in start number 3, put it all together, a 7-length win. Comes in with a 91 Brisnet speed figure. Just Steele goes for the coach, Dwayne Lucas, by Justify. A $500,000 yearling purchase, Joel Rosario rides. And the final two are Northern Flame for Ken McPeak, a big win last out at Churchill Park, 3rd at Ellis Park to Generous Tipper, and also ran 4th to Timberlake at Ellis Park. Rounding out the field is Locked. Todd Pletcher sends out the son of Gunrunner, a 7-length win in the last start at Saratoga. That was in his second lifetime start on the stretch out. Goes from 6 furlongs to a mile, now to a mile and a 16th, Locked with Jose Ortiz at Keeneland on Saturday. Wide open Breeders' Futurity. We've got winners from Churchill Downs, also Ellis Park, Saratoga, and even West Saratoga, the stakes winner in the Iroquois the last time out. Generous Tipper, big win, and Awesome Road, an impressive-looking debut. A mix of contenders here. Top favorites on the board, I think, are going to be Locked and the Wine Steward, who's 3 for 3. Timberlake, that second place finish in a grade one. Generous Tipper, the big win. And then Awesome Road, another one to consider here in the Keeneland Breeders' Futurity, which goes on Saturday. A nine-horse field. Let's take a look at the race replays, get you set up on how they got here. First off, a winner at Saratoga. It was Locked last time out, picking up the big win. I like the fact that it's by Gunrunner. Third lifetime start. Goes a mile and a 16th, a powerful victory in the last race for Locked at Saratoga. Now you've got Timberlake, second in the grade one hopeful, but we're going to go back to Ellis Park, a big win, a 9-length win, drawing off from the field, was bet down that day, and Timberlake, I think, can improve just a little bit here back in Kentucky at Keeneland. Now Awesome Road, sire is Quality Road, a 90 Brisnet speed figure. Big win, first out, impressive looking winner. I like this one, just the way that it was on the inside. Drew off late, and it was the four horse here at the rail. Awesome Road picking up the victory last out. Now you go to the fourth one in the race this time. Generous Tipper, Ellis Park win, sire of Street Sense. This one powers away to the big victory. Faced Timberlake in his debut, then faced another good winner. Generous Tipper, a chance here to still improve and come from maybe a little bit off the pace if there's a lot of pace in this race. So that is a look at some of the main contenders. I think overall the pace is going to be above par. I think pressers are going to have a little bit of an advantage, but remember, with these lightly raced horses, you don't know exactly their running style. I think maybe Timberlake could be helped by the pace here, and possibility of Locked getting an advantage on the pace scenario. Overall, the pace scenario looks like this. Locked and Awesome Road, most likely going to go to the lead. I'm going to take Timberlake, West Saratoga, kind of Just Steal on that stretch out, and Northern Flame. I think they can be up here applying pressure. If all of this happens in the middle, it's definitely going to favor the closer. The closers, I think you got the Wine Steward and Generous Tipper, but again, with lightly raced horses, you're not sure their running style. When all horses only have one race, like Locked and even Awesome Road, you're not sure if they're going to change their running style depending on the size of the field and the pace fractions in race number two. My top selection in the Keeneland Futurity going Saturday is going to be Timberlake. I'm going to take him over Locked, the Wine Steward, and Generous Tipper. Definitely can make the case for the Generous Tipper and even Awesome Road. Wide open Breeders Futurity, a 9-horse field. On Friday, we've got a 9-horse field in the Alcibiades Stakes. You can watch that preview on the channel. We're also going to have previews up later on this week. The Champagne from Belmont at Big A and the Frisette Stakes. Win and you're in for the Breeders' Cup Future Stars Friday. Alcibiades preview is up. You can also watch the author interview with Jennifer Kelly of the Foxes of Bel-Air. More to come on the channel as we get you ready for the Breeders' Cup. Got an update on this last weekend, Super Saturday. Classic implications with Slowdown Andy winning and also the Santa Anita Sprint Championship going to a nice winner in that one. A duel down the lane, but Dr. Shivel getting the victory. Watch the Breeders' Cup updates. We've got lots of 2-year-old stakes races this week, and my top selection is going to be Timberlake. But as Dwayne Lucas says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.